Hi guys, so today I'm going to be filming my very long awaited vacation fragrances. So what I was going to do is show you guys the fragrances that I took with me to Bali. If you don't know, I just got back from a 2-week little vacation. I went to Bali, Indonesia, and it was just so fantastic. I went quad biking, I went snorkeling, I did so many different things, stayed in so many different places, and I really got the chance to like disconnect and relax and just enjoy my time there, which was really nice. But I do really miss working because I love doing YouTube, I love making videos, and I love talking to you guys, so I'm happy to be back. And yeah, so what I'm gonna do today is kind of combine the two topics. So I'm gonna do, this list is massive, by the way, it's freaking massive. There's like 20 fragrances here. So I have the fragrances that I took with me to Bali, which I will mention which ones they are, but I also incorporated fragrances that I recommend you take on a vacation. So I have a little bit of everything in here, my recommendations for vacation scents, and also my personal fragrances that I took with me to Bali. So stay tuned if you want to see what I took with me. I didn't take too many fragrances. Actually, that's a lie. I took quite a few fragrances with me. And if you don't know, Bali is like extremely hot, hence why I'm pretty tanned right now, which you can't really see. I got a nice little tan because the Bali sun is so strong. It's so intense, but I love it so much. The first fragrance that I recommend for a vacation is this beauty right here. This is Martin Mikalev Ylang. I did actually take this one with me to Bali because for me, this is a beautiful summer, spring, tropical fragrance. It has vanilla. I would classify it as a vanilla fragrance, but it has a beautiful ylang ylang note in there. Some coconut, which is one of my favorite notes ever, especially when you're going on vacation. I think coconut is prime. Like, it is just the prime note for me personally. I love coconut. I think I have at least 15 coconut fragrances in my collection, which I love. And Ylang in Gold, Ylang is just beautiful. It's a little fruity. It's almost got a little bit of like this plasticky sort of smell, but not in a bad way. It smells incredible to me. So coconut, vanilla, some fruitiness, some Ylang Ylang, some floral. It's beautiful. It's probably one of my favorite like vanilla floral fragrances ever. And yes, I highly recommend it, especially for a tropical vacation. This is one that I do recommend. It may be a little, I don't know, maybe you will agree or disagree, but for me personally, I do feel like this is a vacation scent. This is Tom Ford Shanghai Lily. Now, I also love Sole Blanc from Tom Ford, and I highly recommend it, which I don't own it, sadly. I do want to get a bottle eventually of Sole Blanc. I highly recommend it for a vacation, but I also really love Shanghai Lily. Now, for me, this is like a... You could kind of wear it summer, autumn, winter, spring, but I wouldn't recommend to wear this one in like the heat in the day. I do think that this would be incredible for like a date night scent, for something maybe a little more tropical at night. Definitely don't wear this one in the day under the heat, the intense sun, you're sweating. Don't wear this fragrance at that time. But for me, Shanghai Lily, I want to be, you know, really dressed up. It's a little humid, it's hot, and you throw on Shanghai Lily, you smell classy, beautiful, refined, and just incredible. If you don't know how this smells, as the name would suggest, it's lilies, but it's kind of like a little spicy oriental. There's some cloves, but it's not too intense. That's why I do really love this one, and I do recommend it for like a summer night out. Baccarat Rouge 540 from Maison Francis Kirkshop. I did take this one with me to Bali, and it did really well in the heat. I really do feel like this one works in any time of the year, summer, autumn, winter, spring. I feel like Baccarat works in anything. That could be debatable because it's a very sweet fragrance, so I know some people really do not want to wear sweet in the heat. I personally don't mind it, depending on what sort of sweet fragrance it is. If it's something like, let me try and think of a fragrance, Hypnotic Poison Eau de Toilette from Dior. I would never wear that fragrance in like the really hot heat because it's just too much. Or like Black Orchid from Tom Ford. But something like this, I do think it works all year round and it smells fantastic. If you don't know how it smells, it's a beautiful, sweet, airy, I always say like burnt sugar. It smells like when you put sugar into a pan and it kind of like caramelizes and turns like into that burning sort of smell. That is what the fragrance smells like to me. Love it so much. I actually have a fragrance in here that I like to mix it with, which I will share with you guys after. So Maison Francis Kurkdjian Baccarat Rouge 540. Okay, so next up we have Christian Dior's Gris Dior. As you can see, I use this all the time, and oh my god, for me it's like my signature scent. I wear this all the time. It's the fragrance that I wear when I say, I don't know what to wear today. I have no idea what to wear today. I'm feeling overwhelmed. I don't know, and I wear Gris Dior. It's a beautiful vintage oak moss, rose, patchouli, fresh, fizzy, some bergamot in the opening. It's just beautiful. It's one of my favorite fragrances like ever. It's not super intense and heavy and thick. It's a beautiful, fresh, vintage oak moss, rose patchouli scent, which I love. So Gris Dior from Christian Dior, definitely a huge compliment getter for me as well. I feel like this one just works really well on my skin, hence why I made it my signature. So Gris Dior. Next up, we have Tom Ford Orchid Soleil. Now, if you guys watch my channel, you know I had like a love-hate relationship with this scent. When I first tried this scent, I hated it. And then I tested it on my skin a few times and I ended up really loving the way that it smells. So for me, this is definitely a very love or hate scent. I feel like all of this line, the Orchid line or whatever you call it, is a very love or hate. I feel like you will either really love them or really hate them. Orchid Soleil is a beautiful tuberose scent, but it's very, very unique to me. Like, very unique. It has like a whipped cream note, which you definitely smell, but it's not too much, it's not too sweet, it's not too intense. And for me, I feel like this one really works well in the heat. Like, surprisingly, for being such like a intense, weird fragrance of like tuberose and whipped cream, it works really well in the heat. And I have a little advice for you guys. Guys really love this scent. For some reason, guys go crazy for Orchid Soleil. Not sure what it is, which kind of surprises me because tuberose is a little more of an older, more mature note. I'm not sure what it is, but guys, they really love this scent. So for me, I recommend wearing this one. I recommend wearing this one like on a hot night out, like maybe a dinner. You're going for dinner on the beach. It's hot, it's humid. Wear this fragrance. Of course, of course, of course. Delina, Delina, Delina. Of course, I took this with me. I took this with me to Bali because I love Delina, and for me, it's just a fragrance that I know is gonna smell incredible. Like, I know I'll smell incredible when I wear Delina. And this is the original. I didn't take the exclusive with me, which you guys know I usually mix them. I didn't take the exclusive. I just took the original Delina because it's beautiful. It's got a little bit of a freshness to it, but it's still floral. It's rose, peony. It's plush. It's velvety. It's a little powdery. It's a little fresh. There's a rhubarb note in there, which gives it kind of like a sour hint to it, which I really love. And I think it kind of gives it a unique twist. Whereas, you know, there's a lot of rose peony scents that are pretty boring, pretty like one dimensional. This has like a lot more going on. I have very, very, very great experiences with compliments of this fragrance from guys. So if that means something to you, then I will tell you this is one of my most complimented fragrances from men. So keep that in mind. But it's just a fragrance that I personally love so much, and you guys already know that. So Delina from Parfum de Mali. So let's go to this one, Guerlain Terracotta Le Parfum. Now, I was almost going to include this fragrance as well. Sorry, my nails, like two of them have come off. It looks really bad. okay, so I was almost going to include this fragrance right here, which is Estee Lauder Bronze Goddess. But I said, like, I'm going to leave it out of the list because this fragrance smells, they're kind of in the same world. They definitely smell pretty similar to me, like tuberose, floral, coconutty, goddess sort of thing. But this fragrance has the worst longevity I've ever experienced in my life. It's gone in like 3 seconds. So that's why I'm not going to recommend it. Although the scent is fantastic, I love the way it smells. The quality and the juice, it's the weakest juice I've ever experienced. So leave that, don't buy that fragrance. And I would recommend going for Terracotta Le Parfum from Guerlain. Now, and personally, I actually even like this one better. So this is coconut, tiara flower, coconut, white floral, some gardenia. oh my god, it's just amazing. It's tropical, beautiful, that beachy goddess. For some reason, I see this on a really tanned girl with brown hair, and she's really hot. She has like a really amazing body, and she like spritzes this on. Of course, that doesn't fit me at all, but I still wear this fragrance, and I still love it, and it makes me feel like that so much. So for me, I recommend this literally anytime you're on vacation. Wear it on the beach, wear it to lunch, wear it to breakfast, wear it anytime where it's nice and hot, and it will just project off of your skin and just smell phenomenal. So Terracotta Le Parfum from Guerlain. I am really excited because this is a new discovery. I'm about to do another video. I'm going to be filming all day today because I have so much catching up to do, of new fragrances that I'm loving, which this is one of them, and I'm so excited. I was so excited to talk to you guys about it. I did take this with me to Bali because I had to. I just got it before I left. I got it like 2 days before I left, smelled it, tested it, and fell head over heels in love with this scent. This is from Nishane, and this is called Annie. This is currently one of my most favorite vanilla fragrances ever. This fragrance is incredible. It is the most beautiful vanilla fragrance. It's really unique. It has a little bit of a unique twist to it, and I'm gonna tell you guys why. Oh my god. It smells amazing, you guys. Like, absolutely incredible. I kind of have been steering away from vanilla, and I'm gonna tell you guys why. Because I feel like everything smells really similar. Every single vanilla fragrance that I've tried recently all smells really similar. So this was such a pleasant surprise for me. Like, honestly, I was so happy when I got it because it's something different. It's not too thick, too sweet, too heavy, but the dry down, definitely it becomes a lot sweeter and much more vanilla heavy. In the opening, you get a beautiful, which I think is why it attracted me so much. It has a beautiful ginger note, which gives it kind of like this spicy punch to it. But like I said, in the dry down, it becomes a little more thicker, a little more sweeter, and it's just amazing. And I got many, many, many compliments with this scent when I was in Bali, so keep that in mind. I don't recommend this just for vacation, but I wanted to include it in this list because I wore it for me on vacation. So Nishane Annie. The other Parfum de Mali, I promise, there are only two Parfum de Malis in here. And this is Meliora. For me, I love Meliora. It's such an easy wear. I would say that it is one of the most likable scents from Parfum de Mali for women. I would say this and maybe Delina, maybe Safanad. I feel like they're all very likable, but absolutely Meliora is the most likable from Parfum de Mali for women. So if you don't know how this smells, it's kind of like a fruity, fresh, it's fruity, but yet very refreshing, which is what I really love about it. It has almost a little bit as well of a pininess to the scent, like a, not a pine forest, but almost a little bit. I don't know what it is, but this fragrance really makes me feel like refreshed when I put it on. Again, I don't know why, but it does, and it was perfect for me to just spritz on. You're hot, you don't know what to wear, you smell fantastic. So Meliora from Parfum de Mali. This fragrance is where it all began for me, and I did take this one with me to Bali, and I'm gonna show you guys the next fragrance is what I like to mix it with. And wow, I totally love this scent so much. I've loved it. This is probably one of the fragrances that I have loved for the longest period of time in my life. Pacific Rock Moss from Goldfield and Banks. The best aquatic I've tried. It's salty, aquatic, fresh, juicy, some grapefruit, some geranium. It's a little bit sweet. It's just incredible, guys. Like, it's absolutely incredible, and I cannot recommend a more perfect fragrance for a tropical vacation. If you're a guy, if you're a girl, you can share it. You can share it with your partner. Spritz it on any time of day. You can wear it in the day, in the night, absolutely any time. For me, I wear this one more during the day when I've come out the shower, when I want something refreshing. Sometimes you're a little bit hot. You don't really want to wear a fragrance because they can be quite disruptive when you're really, really, really hot. This is the sort of fragrance that I wear. So Pacific Rock Moss, my little baby, from Goldfield and Banks, Australia. From my home. So yeah, I love this fragrance. I'm not biased. I honestly just love the scent so much. So get on it 100%. Now, I'm going to mention something right now. Now, you guys have asked me for the longest time what I think about Jo Malone fragrances. Now, I'm going to be honest. I do really like a lot from Jo Malone. My only problem is that this line, the cologne line, has the worst longevity. that I've ever experienced in fragrances. Besides Estee Lauder Bronze Goddess, these take the cake for having like the worst longevity, and they're expensive. Like, they are expensive scents. Jo Malone is not cheap. So for me, it does kind of bother me that they don't last. I know the Cologne Intense line does last a really long time on the skin. I love Myrrh and Tonka. I really want to get a bottle. There's a few others from that line that I love so much. The Velvet Rose and Oud smells exactly like Oud Bouquet. But this fragrance, I could not have this fragrance in my collection. I actually bought it, where was I? Hong Kong Airport. I bought it in Hong Kong. And I just had to have it. And I had smelled it really a long time ago, but I just had to have it in my collection, and it is Wood Sage and Sea Salt. The very famous Wood Sage and Sea Salt. The scent itself, just going off the scent, is one of the most intoxicating, fresh, addictive scents I've ever tried. It's not gourmand, it's not sweet, it just has this incredible scent to it that I cannot put my finger on it. And I'm gonna tell you guys, to me, these two fragrances smell really, really similar. And I know that sounds really weird. Pacific Rock Moss, it has the aquatic note, which Jo Malone doesn't have. But there is sage, which they both have sage in them, which I can really tell in both of the fragrances. It's definitely, they've both got like a salty note in there, a little bit of a juiciness, like a little fruity, juicy, citrusiness. So there is a lot of similarities, and that's why I love to mix these two fragrances together. So Wood Sage and Sea Salt, I totally love the scent. I just wish it lasts longer, but it is my perfect fragrance. It is literally my perfect fragrance that I like to spritz on when I just get out the shower. Like, when I just get out the shower, this is the fragrance that I spritz on. Next up is a fragrance that you guys have never heard me talk about, so I'm going to try and go a little faster. This is from The Gate, which is a niche fragrance house, which I smelled for the first time in New York, and I fell in love. I fell in love with like so many of their scents, and this was one of the fragrances that I did take with me to Bali. It is called Inside Out. Now, this is a beautiful like floral vanilla. There's an ice cream note in here, which you totally get like this sweet kind of gourmand vibe to it, but not too much. There's some frangipani, which is why I wanted to take it with me to Bali, because frangipanis are everywhere in Bali, and I just love the scent so much. I think they're so beautiful. So to me, let me see. Oh my God, it's just heavenly. It's like a floral vanilla. There's a little bit of like a creamy milkiness to it. It's addictive, it's sexy, it's long lasting. All of The Gate fragrances actually really last a very long time on your skin, like a very, very, very long time. So keep that in mind. So I'm gonna try and go a little faster, but amazing fragrance. I will talk a little more about it. But if you like gourmands and a little bit of a floral touch, like just a little, there's not too much of a floral, it's not overbearing or overpowering. But if you like your gourmands, wow, this is amazing. My baby, Santal Complete. Oh my God. It's still to this day one of my favorite scents in the entire world. Coconut, lemon, violet. It's powdery, soft, just incredible. It smells like fairy dust. It smells like crushed pixie dust. It smells magical. It's creamy, coconutty, sandalwood. It is hands down one of my favorite fragrances in the entire world, and it always will be. So Santal Complet, everyone that has bought this fragrance has literally messaged me and said, wow, like wow, 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 wow. Thank you so much for letting me, like for introducing me to this fragrance, because it is incredible. It truly is a magical fragrance, and Fragrance Ivoire is one of my favorite houses. Mikalev, watch. This is Tuberose Vanilla. It smells almost identical to Mancera's Velvet Vanilla, but this fragrance smells a lot more natural, which is why I chose to include this one and not Velvet Vanilla, because I feel like for vacation, Velvet Vanilla is too much. It's a little bit too strong, whereas this one is perfect. Wear it in the heat, wear it for a summer night out, vacation night out, you're golden. Tuberose and vanilla. That is literally all I get in this scent. Tuberose, vanilla, bubblegum tuberose, sweet, addictive, amazing. This is another one that you put on straight out of the shower when you're not really feeling like wearing a fragrance, it's too hot, you don't want anything to disturb you. Here, this is your fragrance right here. Pacific Rock Moss, this, Jo Malone, Chanel Chance Eau Fraiche. Now this is very, very, very refreshing, juicy, lemon, woody, a little bit aromatic. bitter. It's very strong. It lasts a really long time, which I really love about this fragrance. It lasts a really long time on your skin for being more of a fresher scent. So Chanel Chance Eau Fraiche, highly recommend it when you just kind of want to smell clean, you want to smell fresh, you don't want to disrupt anyone. Perfect. And a massive compliment getter for me. Like, look how much I've worn of this. I get ridiculous compliments when I wear this one. Next up is Laurent Mazzone's Radical Water Lily. Now, I did not take this one with me, and I wish that I did, because it's one of the only citruses that I like to wear. Dolce & Gabbana Light Blue Intense, I love it, but it doesn't last on my skin at all. This fragrance lasts a really long time on my skin, and it's along the same line. So it has some light florals, light. It's not like a heavy tuberose scent. It's more like the light, refreshing, airy sort of florals, like white florals. Some citrusiness. It smells a little bit similar to Maison Francis Kurkdjian Aqua Universalis. It does smell pretty similar to this one, but I love this so much. And like I said, it lasts a really long time on my skin, which I really appreciate. For me, this is again something that you wear to breakfast, you wear it to lunch. I mean, you could wear it in the night, but I would go for something a little more sexy. But it's perfect. Just spritz on. You smell incredible. You smell likable. You smell really pretty. To me, this also kind of smells a little bit like a... I feel like you could wear this to like a wedding or something like that. So Laurent Mazzone Radical Water Lily. One of my favorite fragrances in the entire world right now. Like, in the entire world. Oud for Greatness from Inicio Parfums. Wow, 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 wow. I did take this one with me to Bali. And this was my sexy night out fragrance. This was my, I'm going to dinner, I'm dressed up, I really want to feel sexy and mysterious. This is what I wore. I am obsessed with this fragrance. I cannot rave about it enough. To me, it is 100% a masterpiece. It's smoky. It's a little bit of like a, it definitely has an oud note, but it's so like so refined, so smooth. Oh my God, it's just amazing. To me, this is what I get. A smoky, incense-y oud, but really, really refined. Just make sure that you keep that in mind, with a hint of a sweetness in there, which makes it kind of addictive. Masterpiece fragrance. I honestly have not loved a fragrance this much in a really, really, really long time. And I do want to tell you guys, one second, I actually love to mix these two. I really love mixing these two fragrances together. I'll do a little more of Oud for Greatness and then like two spritzes of Baccarat, and it smells insane. Next one, Armani Privé Rouge Malachite. Okay, these three, the Oud for Greatness, this and my last one, were my like most worn fragrances on vacation in Bali. These were my most worn. Rouge Malachite, I am totally obsessed with this scent. I cannot say it enough. This is easily one of my top favorite fragrances right now. In my top three for sure. It's a sexy, delicious tuberose scent, but it's not too much. It's not too sweet. There's almost like a little bit of like a cinnamon sort of smell to it as well. And I'm just obsessed. It's kind of ambery, sexy, along the lines of Alien, but in a tuberose fragrance. So if you can understand what I mean, it's got that sexy, a little indolic sort of vibe to it from the amberiness, but the tuberose is not intense, which is why I love this fragrance so much. The tuberose is not overbearing. It's not intense. It's just perfect, like perfection. So Armani Privé Rouge Malachite, easily one of my favorites. And I get so many comments, so many comments on this fragrance. So there you go. My final fragrance, I put it on my Instagram story actually and told you guys that this was one of the only fragrances that I took with me. And it is my baby, my other baby. Look how much I've already worn of this. I don't know if you can see that. This is Oud Jeune Intense from Fragrance du Bois. I said that already. Fragrance du Bois is easily one of my favorite houses. They can do no wrong. Their scents are phenomenal. I know they are extremely expensive, but I cannot stop. Like, I cannot stop wearing them. I love them so much. It's insane. Oud Jeune Intense is perfection. Same with Santal Complet, but this one is more intense. Tiare flower, some fruit, some coconut. Oh my God. I literally cannot describe this scent. There's some oud in the bottom, but you really don't smell the oud to me personally. It's more of like this intense, floral, fruity, incredible scent. Like, it is absolutely incredible. It's addictive. It's sexy. It's feminine. I'm just obsessed with it. So I also want to mention, I have the oil here. It's called Aseal, And I never thought in my entire life that I would be into oils, but I've been using, like, this literally came with me to Bali. I like to put the oil behind my ears, behind my neck, a little bit in my chest, and then go ahead and spray a few spritzes of this on. Like, incredible, 10 out of 10. So yeah, that is it, you guys. I'm so sorry the video was kind of rushed, but I was trying to get it under 30 minutes and I feel like I did a really terrible job. Okay, thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll talk to you guys soon. Bye.